This is the Elegant Oxford. We specialize and offer premium shoe shines, dyes, and artisan patinas for quality men's brands and help others to learn the art of shoe shining. Visit theelegantoxford.com for all of your shoe care needs. So, let me just start off by saying that if you've watched my channel for some time or know anything about me, you'll know that I'm absolutely obsessed with Spade soles. Now, when I mention Spade soles in posts or in videos, a lot of people aren't sure at all what that means, since it's not something you see very commonly anymore. A Spade sole is a fine detail added to shoes that was very prominent in the golden era of American shoemaking back in the 1940s. The sole of the shoe is cut in such a way that it resembles a spade shovel, with sharper lines and a pointed front. If you look at vintage magazine ads, almost every high-end shoe was constructed using a spade sole. Now, of course, in my opinion, they look very regal and accentuate lines and angles that give the shoe a very dynamic look. And in high-end shoemaking, dynamic lines and sharp angles are really desired, and generally, the clunkier, bulbous, and thicker shoes are less desired by some aficionados. Now, you might be surprised to learn that my love for this look started when I was a kid. I was a huge fan of Batman the Animated Series, and I noticed that whenever Bruce Wayne wore a suit, he portrayed the ideal image of men's fashion, especially in later team-up shows like Justice League Unlimited. He had huge shoulders and a very skinny waist, and his shoes looked dynamic and sharp. Now, if you look carefully at how the animators drew Bruce Wayne's shoes, you'll notice they have a spade shape. It just gives the shoe an incredible silhouette, really the ideal shape of what a dress shoe should look like by narrowing the waist of the shoe and having the spade cut a sharp line by the ball of the foot to the front of the shoe. The elongated front part of the spade gives the appearance of a sharper and more chiseled toe. Men's clothes in general seeks to accentuate the positive aspects of the male form, and this is especially evident with suits or blazers. Slight padding or even heavy padding enlarges the man's shoulders so they look bigger, while his waist appears thinner and tighter overall. So, this is also why tailored suits and clothing has become so wildly popular today. It's just another effort to accentuate the human body in a positive way. Whether it succeeds or fails, or is a good idea or a terrible one, that's just what it seeks to do. So, for example, if you're Daniel Craig playing James Bond, your suits fit amazingly well, first and foremost, because you're in fantastic shape. But if you're an average Joe, you can give the appearance that you're in better shape than you actually are by making sure your clothing is tailored to fit closer to your body. So I'm not talking about skinny jeans at all, but I can say very confidently that very loose-fitting pants are out, and slimmer, more trim trousers are in, and I don't see that changing anytime soon. It follows a pattern set forth by men's fashion, which began with the European military uniforms of the British Army hundreds of years ago. Men's clothing today is an homage, or at least was inspired and finds its roots in the clothing of the 1700s and what came and evolved from that afterward, including the button-down white shirt and the suit. So I think most people would be shocked at how much of our clothing actually was inspired by or came directly from military dress, including dress shoes, dress boots, trousers, bomber jackets, and even aviator sunglasses. So, when I first saw the spade sole on a shoe in real life, I was instantly attracted to the look and wondered for a very long time why this feature was no longer a part of the regular fine details you see on shoes today. So after years of wondering, I finally decided to contact Steve at Beatles Leatherworks to see if adding this detail on a shoe was even possible, and Steve did not disappoint. I really wanted the shape of the spade to be a little more subtle than other pairs I've seen just to start off, but if you're interested in seeing how the whole thing was done, Steve has the video of the entire process on his channel, so I'll link it in the description of this video. Without further ado, here it is. I'm really blown away. Steve did an excellent job with shaping the spade. I love the contoured line on the inside and outside of the shoe that tapers nicely as it goes back to the heel. It really gives the shoe a completely different look. Now, one of the things Steve changed about this pair is that he converted them from a 360-degree Goodyear welt to a 270-degree Goodyear welt, which allows the heel of the shoe to come in closer to the back here for a cleaner and slimmer profile. If you compare it to this pair of stock Allen Edmonds strands, which are still 360-degree Goodyear welted, you can see what I'm talking about. The heel and welt stick out farther since the stitching here has to go around the whole shoe. I prefer a 270-degree welt since it allows for a slim tapering at the back. Now, another change Steve made with this resole is he added a higher stitch density with an impressive 10 stitches per inch, while normal stock pairs have about 4 to 5 stitches per inch. It's always good to see that personally, and he also added some jimping on the welt as well, which is always awesome to see. Now, the soles are probably my favorite part. Steve added beautiful JR soles with blind channel stitching, which is already amazing work, but on top of that, he added my initials using nails here on the waist of the shoe and added custom brass toe plates to finish it off. Not to mention he finished the sole off with what I call a Spider-Man blue and red paint job, although technically it's called broken glass if I'm not mistaken, which I actually love like you would not believe. I am so happy and pleased with the final results. I'm glad I finally reached out and looked around for someone willing to take on this project for me. I really hope the Spade sole makes a comeback, but even if it doesn't, it's always going to be a fine detail I absolutely love and appreciate. I really want to thank Steve at Beatles Leatherworks for agreeing to take this on. It's just something I've been wanting to do for such a long time. Alright, here is the before. As you can see, it's the stock Allen Edmonds sole and welt. And here is the final product. Hope you enjoyed as much as I do. Thanks for watching. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. Please like, subscribe, and share for more content in the future. Make sure to check out my other videos as well if you'd like to learn more about shining your shoes. Look for me on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter at The Elegant Oxford for more. Remember to care for your shoes so that they'll last you for years to come. Always put your best foot forward. The small details matter most, so don't forget to hashtag shine your shoes. I'll see you next time.